This sculpture represents how the way you look does not define you, your sexuality, or your gender identity. Each facial feature is different and unique, highlighting the differences within us and between us, but still standing together as a community. As you look inside the head, you will see the rainbow brain is all its pride, showing that when we put our minds together, we can create something truly beautiful.
LGBTQIA+ young people deserve the freedom to walk down the street holding hands with the person they love without fearing for their safety. This artwork captures the homophobia experienced by LGBTQIA+ young people in Ireland by inscribing statistics on a body that reaches out to share personal stories. The work confronts the reality that despite progress marked by, for example, marriage equality and the Gender Recognition Act, many LGBTQIA+ young people still worry about offending people and are scared of rejection from friends and family and fear violence against them.
The artist combines a series of portraits with poetry documenting his journey as a young transgender man. The center drawing is his depiction of gender, which is surrounded by his poetry. These represent the poet's queer experience. Portraits of important figures surround this. The digital portraits are contemporary figures, and the hand-drawn portraits are historical queer people. They have all had an impact on the artist's life.
In 2017, the Irish Blood Transfusion Services lifted their lifetime ban on men who have sex with men, MSM, donating blood and platelets. This ban was replaced with a 12-month referral period where MSM must be abstinent. This has little basis in scientific fact. Blood and platelets donations save lives. In this 12-month period, someone could have donated 4 bags of blood or 13 bags of platelets.
This installation represents the idea that being LGBTQIA+ is not a choice, it's who you are. Individual strands of rainbow wool represent the DNA double helix in which heart-shaped pride flags are suspended, symbolizing a living body. Positive and negative phrases associated with the community are written inside each heart. They show that people's words are carried in and affect queer minds, bodies, and souls. The work demands that anti-LGBTQIA+ rhetoric be challenged and queer young people be heard and supported, now more than ever.
This piece is demonstrating the different strata of a person's face, or outer layer, that the world sees, then contrasting that with the feelings and emotions under the surface, represented by the fragment of the face which appears to come from an opening in the chasm under the skin. These two layers are contrasted with the most internal layer, the mind, whose contents resemble something familiar but incomprehensible.
My work represents how society has created gender norms that don't fit everybody, and this can create confusion and self-doubt. This confusion consumes a grey figure that finally breaks through the binary gender society imposes. I believe people should be free to explore and identify with whatever is comfortable for the individual. It can be very difficult and frustrating to try and fit yourself into a box, as not everyone is made for the box.
These portraits illustrate a journey of self-acceptance, battling internalized and societal homophobia. As the portraits progress, the face becomes clear, developing with the person's acceptance of their own identity and those of the LGBTQ+ community.
This filmed contemporary dance, layered with an animation revealing my heart, tells the story of a journey towards self-discovery. It shares moments of confusion and darkness, followed by acceptance, belonging, and contentment.
Using the mannequin as a canvas, this work combines drawings and words and phrases, each papier-mâché onto the body. I use drawings alongside words and phrases to represent what members of the LGBTQ plus community go through on a daily basis. The project aims to get the attention of people outside the community and make them aware of the problems that young LGBTQ plus people face.
Fear. How I feel your touch long after. I hate the way you, the daisy I picked, to my sweet boy, to the love of my life, typical love.
The central theme of this photo series is the meaning of words. The meaning of words refers to the literal definitions of the words featured in the pictures, but also to the interpretations of the people who hear them and are described by them, and how a word can be a reclaimed source of pride for some, and simultaneously be a source of shame and pain for others.
In this short film, Jay, a young trans man, recalls his pivotal experiences from growing up with his allying parents who supported him in his transition. He speaks about how that felt, how it shaped his life for the better, and how you could be an ally to your children too.
The most important thing to take away from this is that we need to listen and be open to what trans young people have to say.
My piece is a trans 101, so what does that mean? It is a basic introductory video to explain what trans people go through. This video is for people who don't know what trans people go through or who trans people are. I hope you find it educational and informative.
This work, combining sculpture and poetry, is my response to my experiences growing up queer. Growing up as a queer female forced me to mature faster. I struggled under the weight of other people constantly making judgments or passing comments about me, and I felt a disconnect between how others saw me and how I saw myself. I'm now learning how to take back my power and practice self-sovereignty.
I wanted to capture how humanity is stripped away from the community when they are looked upon by society through an objectifying and sexualized lens. Homophobic and transphobic acts of violence are all too common in Ireland, and the onus should not be on the LGBTQIA+ community to solve this issue.